I want to give you a presentation about another one of the thematics in Immunet. It's about bathymetry, making the best digital bathymetry for Europe. And that's a project I'm here on behalf also of Thierry Smeet from SHOM and Sjors Poelstra, but of course also on behalf of the whole consortium, because we have now 41 partners. And they are really from hydrographic services and also from marine research institutes. And the nice thing is they are complementary to each other, because one part is measuring more, let's say, the fairways and the maritime channels, etc. And others are more interested in features in the seabed. And they nicely complementing each other. Well, in the beginning we thought it would be difficult. But now we have a very nice team who are doing a great job. And I will show you what we have done. So what we do, we bring together, let's say, all the surveys that we can, the survey data in Europe from European originators. And we make them discoverable. But also we use them as input to create the best digital bathymetry for the European seas. And over time, we are improving the resolution, because we started in the beginning. There was JEPCO, that's our benchmark, that is the global bathymetry, and they have a 1 kilometer grid. And we said we want to do a little bit higher resolution, so we went for 0.5 kilometer, 500 meter. And in the beginning, we met some resistance from some providers. Let's say they said, well, it's difficult. We don't want to release all our data at that level. But over time, they went along and the product came out. And then the next round, we said, let's go now to 250 meter. And again, we met some resistance, but there was already, a user crowd who said, we want more, we want more. And we love what you're doing. And that gave a lot of enthusiasm to go further. And also to convince the bosses that they should release more data. And right now, we just released one at 150 meter by 150 meter. And this is not the end. We want more. But we'll see. We have to discuss with our providers and with their bosses and with the ministries whether they can release, let's say, more in the higher resolution. But we'll see. Okay, so what we do is we make this, we work on this digital terrain model since 2008. We have several releases. And we also make it, of course, available for the users in a portal with very nice viewing services and for downloading, because the product is fully open in the spirit of Immunet. Another thing that we do in the latest round, we are also now generating and publishing the best estimate the European digital coastline, and at different tidal levels. LAT, lowest astronomical tide, mean sea level, and mean high water. And I must say, in the beginning, I was a little bit surprised that we don't have a digital coastline, but while doing the project, we found out that there is really work to do there. So we have now the consortium. Over time it grew from 2008. We are now 41 organizations, 20 countries. And as I already said, we have research institutes, we have hydrographic services, and we have also a couple of, private companies for different reasons. And also we have a strong relation with the international community, like, let's say, the IHO, the International Hydrographic Organization, JEPCO, of course, because we work together and we also have synergy. We exchange to each other our products and we enrich our products together. IPCAO, which is more the Arctic waters. The new project, Seabed 2030, where they want to improve the JEPCO, let's say, bathymetry for the whole globe. And you can see Immunet bathymetry as a regional contribution to that work. AORA is the Atlantic Research Alliance, where we work together with, different countries over the Europe and USA, mostly, over the Atlantic. The North Sea Hydrographic Commission and also the Baltic Sea Hydrographic Commission. And what we saw is in the project, and that's the nice thing of teamwork, you see that in the beginning we had a little bit formalized cooperation, and the North Sea Hydrographic Commission and Baltic, they still had their own products. But now they're fully in the team, and they all refer now to the joint product as also their output. And this way you can really bundle all those resources and turn it into products that everybody, you make common products, but you use them for your the different objectives. Standards are instrumental, as usual. So we adopted the CData standards, and also we enrich them. So we adopt and adapt those standards to make them fit for this work. And we already heard a lot about this, so I won't repeat it. The data gathering, we use the CDI servers, and we have, up till now, we collected more than 27,000 surveys from European originators, and they are managed by 42 data centers from 21 countries. And we have 262 data originators who originally collected those data sets and handed them over, to those data centers who then make them available through this network. They're all available and accessible. We also have what we called composite DTMs, but not always a party was allowed or was able to give or bring in the equation, let's say, their survey data, but then they had a composite DTM. And especially with a lot of hydrographic services, they maintain composite DTMs. So they take the latest surveys, and with this, they enrich their model for the composite DTM. And those we brought together also as an input. And they are also fully described with the same, with let's say, the ISO metadata in the Sextant catalog that is also posted on the portal. Then the process flow is quite simple, you would say. We have survey data, we have composite data. We have a common methodology. We have a common piece of software called GLOBE, which is maintained and has been developed and has been maintained by IFREMER. And we have then regional groups. So we have all the regional seas in Europe. We have a coordinator per basin. We have people providing and pre-processing their data to the coordinator. The coordinator using the common methodology. And then we have one party who does the full integration. And then we have the European DTM. And that's quite a nice piece of work. I'll show you here. So here we have something of the GLOBE software, how that works. It's you can load the survey data and then you can process, you can merge data sets, you can find the best fit, because in some areas we have multiple surveys over time, and depending, let's say, on the quality or depending on the accuracy, depending on the instrument or the date, people make choices. Another thing is that what you see is here is an example of, this is the Atlantic near the Iberic Peninsula. And you see on the left, you see the data that we have from surveys. But you see it's not fully coverage, and then we complete that with JEPCO. That means that we use JEPCO to complete the missing parts, the gaps. JEPCO is for a major part, or let's say a part is based upon altimetry, which has less precision. But of course, where we have data, let's say it has a higher precision. And what is happening now is that JEPCO, we use JEPCO in this way to complement our gaps. But also the result of AMONET bathymetry is given back to JEPCO, and they use that to enrich their JEPCO database, because then they can also take advantage of all the data, the higher resolution data, which is underpinning the AMONET data model. And that's we call it a symbiosis. It really works quite together. Over time, we released several versions of the DTM with different resolutions, as you can see here. And also with different coverage, because in the beginning we had only a pilot, a few selected areas, but now we have full scale all of Europe, from the equator up to the Arctic, all the regions. And in September, quite recently, we released the 8th release, and it has this resolution of 1/16 arc minute, which is about 150 meter by 150 meter. And it also includes now the coastal zones. And it includes in the viewer also 3D visualization, let's say without plugin, but in the viewer. This is the portal. And on the portal, you see immediately what we're doing, what we're aiming for. On the left, you see the survey data sets. On the right, you see the composite DTMs. And in the middle, you see the DTM. And if we go there, this is the DTM right now. It's the in one of the color sets, one of the legions. Here you can have a menu, let's say, with layers. So we have different layers. We can also do different legends. In this case, we took a legend which is better for shallow waters, like the North Sea. So you can very nicely see all the banks and the sea dunes, sand dunes, sorry. Here we see an overlay for the CDI layer. So we have the measurements or the observations, they are overlaid. And you can click on any part and you can get the metadata from the CDI servers about this specific data set. What we do here, but also you have a source reference map, because not every survey is being used for the DTM. There's a selection, and the selection is here in this composite, in this mosaic. So you can see here which is the predominant survey that has been used to make that collection. And you see, again, you can click on an item, and then you get the metadata from the composite catalog or from the survey catalog. But what you also see in this case is, again, you see a gray area in the central North Sea, which is quite remarkable, because you would say it's very heavily surveyed. It has been surveyed, but then by private companies, and we still have some catch-up to do there, let's say, to get more data from them, because there are a lot of oil and gas activity in that gray zone. Luckily, it's quite a stable area. It's minus 20 meters and it's quite flat. So in this case, but we use their JEPCO, and we also have the download facility. There is the 2016 version which you can download in 16 tiles, but the 2018 version has now 64 tiles because the resolution is higher. That means that the tiles are larger, and one tile is about 1 to 2 gigabytes of data. On the right, we have let's say a form by which you can help to fill your request, and then we also ask people to make themselves known and to also tell us why they are using this data set or why they're interested. And I must say that that's something that from the start we already had. We did first without any form, but now we do it with the form. But everybody gives really serious answers about why they are using the data, and there's no AAA, BBB or whatever. It's all real reasons, and also very sophisticated reasons. Let's say it's really the whole spectrum of the society. You see people use it for science, they use it for numerical modeling, but they also use it for pipeline planning, they do it for wind park siting, and all these kind of things. Okay, then we have the 3D visualization. So this is another view on the Canary Islands. Maybe you've never seen it like this, but it's really beautiful. And if you play with this tool in the browser, you can see much more of these sites. You can turn them around, and amazing. We have web servers, of course, because these servers are shared by many other portals. So we have a cooperation with different lots, but we also have a cooperation, for instance, with NOAA. They use it in their portal for the Aurora. And many other, let's say, applications. Then something about determining the European coastline. That's done by, we have an inventory. We made an inventory with all the hydrographic services to have the official coastline. But we also try to do it from space. And for that purpose, Deltares, they use the Sentinel-2 and Landsat 8 images, thousands of them, from 2013 to 2018, selected for coastal lines, coastal areas. And they use Google Earth Engine to run them with certain algorithms. In fact, to take out the clouds, to determine the land-water separation. And this is an example, let's say, of the Wadden Sea. It's all about refining that you really can determine where's the water land separation. But also it's important to have that at certain tidal levels because we want to determine the coastline at 3 tidal levels. And for that purpose, we have a global tidal model. And by that model, we can determine, let's say, those levels at every place on the European coastline. And then we can see the timing for which we are selecting the images from the satellite. And then those satellite images, they are being reprocessed, and that leads to the coastline. And here's one example. This is the Camargue near Marseille in the south of France. And there you see in the colors, you see the different coastlines, let's say, at different tidal levels. And of course, the tidal is not so high here, but these are the flooding levels, you would say, at those different times. Because it's quite marshes there, let's say, it's lowlands, wetlands. Closing remarks. Inward bathymetry is a very successful product from the start. We have now circa 10,000 portal visitors per month. We have more than 3,000-4,000 DTM tiles downloaded per month. We have users from all layers of society and really a great feedback. We get a lot of very nice mail, and also people asking a lot of, let's say, sometimes very complex questions, how they want to use it, and they have complex questions. But we have a good team that we can immediately answer them within 1 or 2 days, sometimes the same day. And more products are on our way, digital coastlines, I already mentioned, but also there will be an inventory of baselines, and there will be also a so-called overall quality index, by which it's more better to assess what is the quality of the DTM at every grid cell. And that's highly important for those who use it, for instance, for the seabed habitat. It's one of their factors. Another thing is the last thing, that we are doing this nice project, but still we are missing a lot of data because we have so far 60% coverage. And where we have coverage, it's not always the highest quality. It's also, we have sometimes very old data. Our most old survey is from 1800. And that means that we always are looking for other providers, people that have new data that might be fit in this model. And they get, of course, full acknowledgement in the DTM products, which have a DOI. And there's a landing page. And in that landing page, everybody who is contributing is being mentioned. And this way we make the, the circle complete, I would say. Thanks for your attention.